This is your daily devotional from the Inspired Word of God, January 29th, the faith I live by, sanctified for worship. Psalm 122, verse 1. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. God has given us the whole of 6 days in which to do our work, and has reserved only one to himself. This should be a day of blessing to us. A day when we should lay aside all our secular matters and center our thoughts upon God and heaven. All heaven is keeping the Sabbath, but not in a listless do-nothing way. On this day, every energy of the soul should be awake, for are we not to meet with God and with Christ our Savior? We may behold him by faith. He is longing to refresh and bless every soul. On Sabbath morning, the family should be astir early. If they rise late, there's confusion and bustle in preparing for breakfast and Sabbath school. There's hurrying, jostling, and impatience. Thus, unholy feelings come into the home. The Sabbath, thus desecrated, becomes a weariness, and its coming is dreaded rather than loved. The Sabbath is God's time. He sanctified and hallowed the seventh day. He set it apart for man to keep as a day of worship. We need to cherish and cultivate a spirit of true worship, a spirit of devotion upon the Lord's holy, sanctified day. We should assemble together, believing that we shall receive comfort and hope, light and peace from Jesus Christ. All heaven was represented to me as beholding and watching upon the Sabbath those who acknowledge the claims of the fourth commandment and are observing the Sabbath. Angels were marking their interest in and high regard for this divine institution. Those who sanctified the Lord God in their hearts by a strictly devotional frame of mind, and who sought to improve the sacred hours in keeping the Sabbath to the best of their ability and to honor God by calling the Sabbath a delight. These the angels were specially blessing with light and health, and special strength was given them. Maranatha, the Lord is coming soon.